I'm Geraldine Kline. I am the head of school for High Mowing. High Mowing is a pre-K through 12th grade located in Wilton, New Hampshire, which is on the east coast of the United States. So the East-West program was started a couple years ago, and it is designed to serve students who want to continue the high school world of education. There are many programs in America that are designed for high schoolers from abroad and from China in particular to come do their studies in the States and then further their education in college also in the United States. We are very different in that we offer not only the possibility to have a diploma from high school that allows students to graduate and further their education, but we do it in such a way that we don't ask students from China to completely abandon their background culture. So our East-West program is designed to both educate students in the English-American world of curriculum as well as stay rooted in their language and their knowledge of their language and their culture. So our East-West program is separated in four different sections. Two sections are for students in grade 6 through 8 in middle school, and two sections are for students in high school in grade 9 to 12. So let me tell you a little bit about our middle school portion. Students are offered two different ways they can benefit and participate in the East-West program. The first one is a trimester. So for 3 months, 12 weeks or so, in the winter months, they join High Mowing in the middle school and they are fully integrated into our regular middle school classes. They make friends with our own students, they participate in all different classes, art classes, movement, English, geography, main lessons, the entire curriculum, and they have the opportunity to really develop their English skills, as well as really making day-to-day relationship with teachers, with friends, and experience a little bit of American way of life. So they can have a little bite of what it is like or what it would be like to study in America in the long term. For those who really enjoy that, then they have the opportunity to join us for a whole year as boarding students. But of course, we don't ask those younger students to board in a boarding house. We place them with families. So we call this program homestays. And in that program, they are able then to live in an American family, really practice and hone their English skills, as well as be regular students, again, integrated fully into our middle school program. Now for our high school students, for children who are, or young adults who are moving into grade 9 and are looking to graduate from High Mowing School, we offer also two different possibilities. The first one is a trimester. Any of the three trimesters we offer, either the fall one, the winter one, or the spring one, and they board in our boarding situation in the high school. There, in our dormitories, they will be surrounded by friends from America, but also from abroad. We have about 30% of our students coming from countries all around the world. It varies every year. People from Europe, people from Africa, people from South America, and people from China as well. So they're very well integrated in that international community of the high school. And for one trimester, again, very similar to the middle school, they're able to really have a good taste of what it would be like to study long term in an international boarding school. High Mowing is the only world of school in the world that has a boarding component. It makes for a very rich cultural life and again very integrated learning experience for our students. So the high schoolers can come for one trimester or they can come for a whole school year. If they do come for a whole school year, they have many options in that way. They can do 1 year in High Mowing, either 9th grade or 12th grade, and the remainder of the 3 years remaining for high school in China. They can come for 2 years or they can come for all 4 years. So we offer a lot of flexibility for students to join us and obtain a diploma from High Mowing. The most important aspect is that in order to get a diploma, they do need to join our 12th grade. So for our high school students who join us for a whole year of studies, the particular element of our East-West program is that as a world of school, we offer morning lesson blocks or main lesson blocks, which is a 3 to 4 weeks length of time where the students focus on a particular subject. The way we designed our East-West program is out of the 9 morning lessons we offer in a year, two of them will be offered in the Mandarin language, so the students do not lose their connection with the language and the culture. And two of them will be expanded. They will be taught in English, but with strong component of Chinese culture. So in that way, after a year, 2, 3, or 4 years of experience with us, the students from China who are participating in our East-West program, they will be able to both be well-versed in American culture and the way we teach in World of Education, as well as remain connected to their Chinese roots. Now, many parents who join high Mowing school are surprised by how different it is from a typical high school. One of the very particular elements of living or being a student at high Mowing is you have a lot of choices in the subjects that you can study. One of the concerns that many parents have is, with so many choices, how do I know that my child is well prepared academically? If my child or my student is able to take art courses and tech courses and movement courses and enjoy the countryside and so forth, when do they have time to actually focus on their studies? And will they be prepared to get to go to a nice college or get a science degree or a math degree or become a doctor or, you know, a profession that you're really looking forward to your child getting into? It's a little bit counterintuitive. The answer to the question is, in fact, counterintuitive. We have found with World of Education that through the 100 years of data that we have following our graduates, that engaging in arts and movement and having a balanced life and study life really contributes to the success of our students. So at High Mowing, you will see in the pictures we send you, in the videos on our website, you will see students really enjoying themselves, being happy students. And again, if you wonder, are they prepared to go to college? The answer is yes. They know who they are, they know what they like, and most importantly, they know how to work. So High Mowing School is a small school. And as a small school, what really separates us from larger schools is the level of personal connection that the students have with their teachers. And by personal connection, I mean the really keen interest of the teachers to make sure that the students are well on their way and are not encountering obstacles that come in the way of their studies. They have everything they need, the tools they need, the support they need, and the coaching, you could say, that they need, both to go through their learning as uneventfully and joyfully as possible, as well as prepare for higher education. So while we are a small school and everybody really knows one another, we also put a lot of effort in making sure that the students have individually tailored support systems. Those include also the way we test for the knowledge base. That's one of the reasons why we do not require TOEFL tests prior to their coming. We find that a simple conversation during the interview process gives us enough knowledge about the student's level of English that we are able to then tailor our courses for their need. So some students might have to take a larger number of ESL classes at the beginning until their English level is strong enough, and other students can fall into our courses regularly. We tailor that English as a second language courses individually to each student. So one of the very particular and strong elements of life at High Mowing is the quality of classes. It's obvious, as I pointed out earlier, through the pictures or the videos, you may see that people, children and students and adults, are having a really lovely time. That does not come in the way of the quality of academics, particularly in the science and math. Again, we have a very different approach to teaching science. We look at it not so much from a point of view of learning facts, but from the point of view of the students developing the capacity to find facts themselves. So through our science courses, which are numerous at very many different levels, we train students to be the researchers of tomorrow. That's what we emphasize, is for them to utilize the knowledge base that they have and the tools they have to be the finders of tomorrow. It's the same in mathematics. We have, again, even though we are a small school, we have 9 levels of math. So some students are very talented from the get-go, others are need more practice, and it's a little more effort. We tailor the math courses to the needs of the students. A child who is really talented in math, we may have to find courses outside of our own school, resources outside of our school, to make sure that they are prepared at the top level that they can achieve. At Mowing, we believe that the best way to learn English and to become fluent is to actually practice well beyond the classroom experience. So while we do offer ESL classes, again tailored to the student's own level and capacities, we really think that, and we experience actually, that the best way to master English is to dive in, and through daily encounters and a bit of struggle at first, and then incrementally experiencing one's capacity to master a language. So this is what we provide for a student. We're not so worried about their level of English upon their entrance at Mowing, because we know that through the immersion of the daily life, their English level will rise and really become fluent without them even realizing it. So the mastery of English is definitely not a concern. Parents who call me to ask me, as they try to find the best high school for their students, they ask me, why should I choose Mowing? I have many choices. I can send them just about anywhere in the world, and what makes Mowing so special? And my answer is typically back to what I said earlier. It's the level of attention we pay to every single of our students, really recognizing them as an individual, really thinking and developing programs and approaches to serve their individual path. So that level of personal care is actually very rare in the world today. There are other elements that are very unique to Mowing, and I would say while we share that those set up with other schools, it's a combination of the ensemble of factors that really makes it special. One is Mowing is actually very secluded by many standards, right? We don't have a big city nearby. We have small towns nearby. The community sits atop of a hill, which is beautiful. We have the four seasons. The air is really fresh. Our food is delicious. The students are really surrounded by nature and have the space to really encounter their friends, get to know their teachers, study without being distracted by a big city or overexcitement of the modern environment. To me, that makes it very special. And it makes it very special to the families that have spent their students over the years. There's also an element at Mowing which I find very surprising and really is unique, which is the sense of loyalty that high school students, as they grow into adults, keep for Mowing. It's a high school, it's not a college. And typically, as people grow into their careers, they are attached to the college. But Mowing is very special in that people even in their 50s, 60s, even older, come back to Mowing, to the high school years, because of the quality of life. It's about the lifestyle, the balance, and the care that Mowing provides to the students.